apples up a hopeless sigh. I hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly. From those around I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. I hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Salim Hassani, and you're viewing this program from birth until death. We have with us Sheikh Haytham Al-Haddad. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh, before, in the previous episodes, we've been talking about circumcision. And we'd just like to finish this discussion. An important question is often is, when should the circumcision be done?
Yes, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. To be honest with you, there is no specific dalil. Uh-huh. Regarding the time of circumcision.
Okay.
But it is a matter that has been discussed by doctors, by experts, and they say the younger the child is, the better.
The younger the better, okay.
Yeah. So, generally speaking, if that can be done in a very young age, that would be better.
That would be better.
Yeah.
As you said, there's nothing specific.
Nothing is specific from right. Sharia. And see, whenever there is no specific guidelines from Sharia,
yes,
then the matter will be flexible and what is better for the person.
Okay. Jazakallah khair for that, Sheikh. The next important point which we want to move on to is the aqiqah. I know we've mentioned it briefly, we've touched upon it in some of the previous episodes, but we'd like to start by mentioning, what is the aqiqah?
Yes, bismillah. Aqiqah is to slaughter a sheep,
yes,
or a cow, or a camel.
Okay.
To slaughter a sheep,
sheep
or a goat,
okay,
or a cow,
yes,
or a camel, to show your thankfulness to Allah Jalla wa Ala for giving you this baby.
Okay.
So this is the aqiqah.
Right.
So either aqiqah names the process itself, the
yes,
aqiqah is a name for the process itself, or the aqiqah is a name for the slaughtered animal.
Okay.
This or that. This
yes,
is the general meaning of the aqiqah and what it refers to.
Okay. Right. And the next important question then is, now we've established the aqiqah and the process, when should it be done?
See, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we mentioned in the previous episode. Again, I'll repeat that hadith, and I mentioned that it is a very important hadith.
Yes.
كل غلام مرتهن بعقيقته. Each غلام is attached to his عقيقه.
Yes.
To be slaughtered at the seventh day.
Yes.
So the sunnah is to slaughter the عقيقه on the seventh day.
Seventh day, okay.
That is the sunnah in general. And there are, by the way, there are a number of hadith regarding the aqiqah, that it is a confirmed sunnah. That's why the vast majority of scholars consider it sunnah,
yes,
and some of them consider it even as a wajib.
Right, okay.
Imam Ahmad once said that they asked him a question. If a person is poor, can he borrow or shall he borrow money in order to sacrifice the aqiqah?
Yes.
He said, yes. Listen,
right,
to borrow money,
yes,
to sacrifice a aqiqah. He said, "Arju an yukhlifa Allahu alayhi ahya sunnah." Mm. I hope that Allah Jalla wa Ala give him something better.
Yes.
This is yukhlifa.
Yes.
To give him something better because he what? He gave life to a sunnah.
Right.
So imagine, this is the time of Imam Ahmad.
Yes.
Now, what about our time?
Yes.
Okay, so slaughtering this aqiqah is a very confirmed sunnah, that and it is one of the Islamic symbols that should be propagated.
Okay.
And people should know about it, especially in some non-Muslim communities, whether in the West or in Africa or elsewhere, it should be very visible.
Yes.
That Muslims slaughter this aqiqah,
yes,
to be thankful to Allah Jalla wa Ala for the baby that has been given. Of course, it has a number of social benefits as well.
Yes.
And As I said, there are a number of hadith regarding the importance of aqiqah. One of them is in Sahih al-Bukhari itself, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ma'a al-ghulami aqiqah," means with the baby, there is a aqiqah.
Okay.
As if it is attached to him.
Connected, yes.
Okay. So, فَأَهْرِقُوا عَنْهُ دَمًا وَأَمِيطُوا عَنْهُ الْأَذَى.
Yes.
So, slaughter it and remove the adha, remove the harm.
Okay.
Remove the harm, as many scholars said, removing the harm refers to what? Shaving the head of the baby.
Ah, all right.
And I don't want to get into this subject, and you are a doctor, that, see, when the Prophet ﷺ said removing the harm,
yes,
is the hair that has been left after the birth,
yes,
is it really a harm for the boy or for the baby in general or not? Allahu alam. But anyway, this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, hadith Aisha, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Anil ghulam shatani mukafi'atan wa anil jariya sha." There should be two sheeps to be slaughtered as a aqiqa for a baby boy.
Yes.
And one sheep to be slaughtered as a aqiqa for a baby girl.
Okay.
This is the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And again, it is an authentic hadith. And hadith also, Ummu Qurayz al-Ka'biyya, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, two sheeps for the baby boy, one sheep for the baby girl.
So two for the boy and one for the girl.
One for the girl.
Okay. And that's with regards to slaughtering on the seventh, as you mentioned from the hadith, you mentioned on the seventh day.
On the seventh day.
Now, sometimes within hospitals, in the hospital environment, sometimes the baby may be unwell or may need to be kept in hospital. So the parents are often very busy and maybe they don't have a time to slaughter the aqiqah on the seventh day. What should one do in that situation?
Yeah. First of all, they can assign someone to slaughter it.
Oh, someone, okay, be assigned.
Okay, can be assigned. Also, if they could not, for whatever reason, to slaughter it on the seventh day, they can slaughter it on the, as there is a report by Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, that the aqiqa can be slaughtered, if not in the seventh, then in the 14th day.
Okay.
If not in the 14th day, then on the 21st day.
Okay.
And, you know, some scholars say that as far as the person did not become mature, I mean in terms of the age of puberty,
yes,
then the aqiqah is still valid.
Okay.
And it should be slaughtered.
Okay.
Some scholars even said that if the aqiqah was missed, then it should be slaughtered at any time.
Okay.
Even if the person is old.
Okay.
And he knew that the aqiqah was not slaughtered on his behalf, he or she can slaughter the aqiqah.
Okay.
Some scholars said that the person himself can slaughter the aqiqah, or his father can slaughter the aqiqah on his behalf. If the baby becomes old, if he becomes adult, then the father can still do it. The matter is flexible because at the end of the day, it is a ibadah. Ibadah not in terms of timing.
Yes.
So if we miss it, then the ibadah cannot be done.
Yes.
Okay. It is a ibadah, first of all, itself. And it is better for the ibadah to be done on the seventh.
Yes.
However, if we missed the seventh, it doesn't mean that the ibadah will not be invalid.
Okay.
There will be an element of ibadah in it, which is a slaughtering.
Slaughtering.
And you know, slaughtering is one of the acts that Allah Jalla wa Ala likes the most.
Yes.
Allah Jalla wa Ala says, "Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar," what? "Fasalli li rabbika wanhar."
Yes.
Fasalli, pray to your Lord. Wanhar, according to many mufassirin who explain the Quran, they said what? Slaughter. Qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin. My salah and my nusuk. My nusuk is what? My sacrifice.
Yes.
Sacrifice is general.
Yes.
Whether the aqiqah or whether any other type of sacrifice.
Okay. Jazakallah khair for clearing that up, Sheikh. Also, does this apply to non-Muslims or someone that was a non-Muslim previously, then he accepted Islam, then that would take the same principle as well, that He can do it as well.
He can do it. There is no problem.
Okay.
In him doing it no or problem. In her doing it.
Yeah. Okay. Now, with the actual aqiqa itself, for example, if you have a sheep that's been slaughtered, what does one do with the sheep?
Yeah. Okay, see, in terms of the aqiqa and the guidelines of aqiqa and the age of the aqiqa, etc., the animal itself, and what to do with the animal itself. Many scholars say that there are no specific guidelines, and the Sharia left it and gave an indication that the aqiqa is equal to the udhiya.
Right, okay.
So what is valid for the udhiya, the udhiya, the sacrifice that we do as a qurbani on Hajj time,
yes,
is valid or should be valid for the aqiqa.
Okay.
So in terms of the age of the sheep, the age of the cow, the age of the camel, is there any specific age? Yes, there is a specific age. What is that specific age? Is the same age for the qurbani.
Right.
Can we slaughter other than these three types,
yes,
other than sheep or ram even,
yeah,
or cows or
yes,
camels? No, we cannot. What is the dalil? It is a matter of consensus, except some odd opinions that cannot be considered as valid opinions.
Okay.
And it is same as the qurbani.
Right.
We cannot have a qurbani by slaughtering, for example, a chicken or something like this.
Yes.
No. It is a matter of ibadah.
Mm-hmm.
And anyway, I don't want to get into the discussion of the dalil for that because of time limitation.
Sure.
Just in conclusion, what is valid for aqiqa, okay, is valid, or what is valid for the qurbani is valid
for
aqiqa.
Okay.
They said also similarly, what to do with the aqiqa?
Yes.
They said you can do anything with the aqiqa, but the best is to do with the aqiqa what you do for the qurbani.
Okay.
What to do with the qurbani? You know that most of the scholars said that according to the statement of Al-Hasan Al-Basri that it should be divided into three parts.
Three parts.
One part is for you.
Yes.
The person who slaughtered the haqiqah,
yes,
or slaughtered the qurbani. And one part to be given what? As a sadaqah.
Mm-hmm.
And one part to be given as a hadiyah.
Okay.
This is the best. However, if the person decided to eat it all, there is no problem.
No problem in that.
If the person decided to give it all, there is no problem.
Okay.
Okay? And there are some statements from some scholars, do whatever you like to do.
Okay.
Imam Malik, he used to slaughter aqiqa and invite other people to eat.
Okay.
So an invitation,
yeah,
to be given to people to eat the whole aqiqa,
to eat the whole aqiqa,
is as well valid.
Okay. JazakAllah khair for taking your time to explain this important principle in Islam. You've been tuning in and watching the show From Birth Until Death. When we come back after the break, we'll continue with the discussion. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I'm on my brothers, let us pray. This time is now, do not delay.
Ask Hoda.
If you're still in Mecca or close by to Mecca, then you have to know that you are still in the state of Ihram. As long as it is not for sale, then he does not have to pay zakah for it. Forbade praying witr similar to Maghrib prayer. So whoever prays witr three rak'ahs and sitting after the second rak'ah as if he's praying Maghrib prayer, this is forbidden, this is haram. Euthanasia is permissible with animals but not with human beings. If an animal is suffering, killing an animal for a legitimate reason is permissible. Both are acceptable, but the majority say that after the rukoo is the place of qunut. But both was reported.
Have a question or concern on your mind? Hoda TV decided, based on popular demand, we will be bringing you an additional episode of Ask Hoda with Sheikh Azim bin Luqman Al-Hakim, live from Jeddah, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia.
I'm on my brothers, let us pray. This time is now, do not delay.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to this episode of From Birth Until Death. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before the break, we were talking about the aqiqah and certain rulings that are pertaining to the aqiqah. A question which is often asked is, who should pay for the aqiqah?
Yeah, this is a good question. Of course, ideally, technically, anything related to the expenses of the child should be paid by his father.
Right.
Even if his mother is rich, but it should be paid by the father.
Okay.
So the father is obliged to pay for the aqiqah, full stop.
Yes.
However, if the mother volunteers to pay, if the grandfather, sometimes the grandfather or, for example, other relatives, they want to pay for the aqiqah, that's all right.
Okay. All right. So that's technically. And sometimes what may happen is we find that the baby may die before the seventh day. Now, what should one do in terms of the aqiqah in this situation?
Yes. Some scholars said that if the baby died before the seventh day, then there should be no aqiqah to be slaughtered.
Right.
But the jumhur, most of the scholars said, no, the aqiqah should be slaughtered.
Okay.
Why? Because it is a ni'mah for Allah Jalla wa'ala to have a baby.
Yes.
And that baby will, even if the baby dies, it will be, he will be in Jannah.
Mm-hmm.
The baby will be in Jannah. And according to some scholars, that baby will have the opportunity to intercede for his parents.
Right.
So it is a ni'mah.
Okay.
And here I would like to emphasize on this point that some of us, they do not think that ni'mah means ni'mah in akhirah, after death. Mm-hmm. They only think of dunya.
Right.
They only think of dunya.
Yes.
So if the baby died in this dunya, so what kind of ni'mah? No.
Mm.
It is a big ni'mah for you because you don't know whether this baby will be interceding for you at the day of resurrection or not. Moreover, it is a ni'mah for you that Allah Jalla wa'ala has given you the blessings of a baby and has taken you, that baby, that taken from you, the baby, and you will have sabr, and then you will get what? You will get a reward for that. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned that the person who have sabr when he loses a very close person to him, Allah Jalla wa'ala will give him Jannah.
Okay.
And also, there are a number of ahadith related to this. But my point is, it is a ni'mah anyway.
Yes.
So if that ni'mah was granted to you by having a baby, then go for the opinion, or I prefer to go for the opinion that we should slaughter a aqiqah.
Yes.
If the baby was, if the baby died even before the seventh day. In fact, some scholars mentioned that if the baby, once the ruh has been blown in the baby,
mm-hmm.
in the womb,
yes.
after 120 days,
yes.
then the aqiqah is sunnah, has been established.
Right.
What does that mean? They said that if the baby was born immature and died,
mm-hmm.
or there is abortion, the baby was aborted for yes. whatever reason.
Yes.
Or something similar to this. As far as the baby was alive,
yes.
then the aqiqah is sunnah.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
Now, whether this or that, if the person can sacrifice a aqiqah,
yes.
then that will be good.
Okay.
That will be good. So we should go for that, inshallah.
Okay. Jazakallah khair. And now you mentioned previously the different types of animals that can be slaughtered in terms of the aqiqah. Is there any particular preference as to which one should be slaughtered?
You know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he offered aqiqah on behalf of Hassan and Hussein, rams.
Rams, yes.
Kabshain.
Mm-hmm.
Bibi kabshaini amlahain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, rams.
Yes.
And they are quite big, white with horns.
Okay.
And as the scholar said, it is sunnah to have them as a hadith Ummu Quraib and hadith Aisha, mutakafi'an. Okay. They are very equal to each other.
Equal, yes.
They are very similar to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So this is sort of hoping that the child will be raised up in a very even way, in okay. a very, you can say, healthy way.
Yes.
Okay?
Okay.
So the sunnah is to have a ram.
Okay.
However, if the person could not find a ram,
yes,
sheep or goat,
yes,
then that is be acceptable, provided that the age is the legitimate age. And the age for a ram is 6 months,
yes,
and the age for a goat is 1 year.
Okay, so the age for a ram is 6 months, and for a goat is 1 year.
Yeah, is 1 year.
Okay.
Should be above 1 year.
Should be above 1 year, okay. And now in terms of cooking the aqiqah, is it better for one to cook an aqiqah, or should one just slaughter it and then...
As we said, that either you slaughter it and distribute it in any way,
okay,
or slaughtering it and cook it and invite people, as we mentioned about Imam Ahmed,
yeah,
the matter is easy.
Okay, so
the matter is absolutely easy and flexible.
Flexible.
However, as we said, that the best thing is to divide it into three parts.
Okay.
Whether if you want to cook the part that you are going to give it to the poor people,
yes,
that would be better, of course, because as some scholars mentioned, that will be better because you made it easy for the poor people to consume this meal.
The meat, okay.
Yeah.
And we mentioned as well that for the girl is one sheep, and for the boy we said that there would be two. Is there any particular reasoning for this or any wisdom behind this that we know of?
There is. The scholars mentioned a number of things.
Okay.
Some of them, they said that this is a preparation that... because you know in inheritance law,
mm-hmm,
Allah Jalla wa Ala says, يُوصِيكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ لِلذَّكَرِ مِثْلُ حَظِّ الْأُنْثَيَيْنِ.
Yes.
The male will get double the female, mm-hmm, in terms of inheritance.
Yes.
So this is a matter of preparation,
okay,
or a continuation for the same ruling.
Right.
Some other scholars mentioned that the baby people normally attracted to baby boys more than they attracted to baby girls.
Okay.
So that's why they need to be more thankful to Allah Jalla wa Ala by having baby boys.
Okay.
Some other scholars mentioned the opposite.
Mm.
They said that because baby girls, you have to spend more for baby girls.
Yes.
So Allah Jalla wa Ala does not want it to make it difficult for you,
okay,
by even spending more in the aqiqah.
Yes.
So to slaughter two.
Okay.
Because you know, أَوَمَنْ يُنَشَّأُ فِي الْحِلْيَةِ وَهُوَ فِي الْخِصَامِ غَيْرُ مُبِينَ. Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned about females that they like and they enjoy adornment and jewelry,
yes,
etc.
Yes.
So obviously you are going to spend this,
yes,
for baby girls.
Yes.
So you are going to spend more for baby girls, so don't spend more in their aqiqah.
Okay.
Something like this.
Yes.
So there are different ways of understanding the wisdom, but Allah Jalla wa Ala knows the best, of course.
Okay. And we often hear sometimes about something called an aqiqah al-jadula.
Yes.
Is this, just explain a little bit about this.
Yeah, they said that, and there were a number of reports by Sahaba,
mm-hmm,
by some Sahaba, that whenever you slaughter the aqiqah and you want to distribute it, don't break the bones of the aqiqah.
Right.
As a tafa'ul, to be optimistic that the baby will not have a broken bone as
right.
well.
Okay.
And nothing will be broken in his or in her life.
Okay.
So don't break the bones.
Right.
Jadulans means cut it from the joints.
Okay.
So if you want to cut it into three parts,
yes,
cut it from the joints.
From the joints.
Whatever is possible.
Yes.
And that's why they said also that it is sunnah, once the people are eating the meat of the aqiqah,
mm-hmm,
that they don't break the bone.
Bones.
There were some reports whether they are authentic or not, but it is a confirmed sunnah,
okay,
that the bones should not be broken as well.
Okay. Hmm. And in the event of someone having twins, what should we do?
You know, Al-Hasan al-Basri, sorry, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had grand twins.
Right.
Ali ibn Abi Talib had Al-Hasan, Al-Husayn. Both of them were twins.
Yes.
Now, they said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam slaughtered kabshain for each one.
Okay.
Some said no, kabshain for both.
Right.
Yani two rams for Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn.
Yes.
And some scholars said no, two for Al-Hasan, two for Al-Husayn.
Yes.
There were even some reports that kabshan, one for Al-Hasan and one for Al-Husayn, and this supports the opinion that it is what? Two for both.
Okay.
However, we say that if the person has enough money, then he should go for the best.
Okay.
And the best is what? Two for each.
Okay.
Of the twins. If he had one boy, one girl, and if he wants to have two that covers both, that will be good.
Okay.
Or it is better, as we said, to have two for the boy and one for the girl.
Okay. Jazakallah khair for this information, Sheikh. You've been watching the program from birth until death with our esteemed Sheikh Haytham al-Haddad. Inshallah, in the next episode, we'll be continuing and going through more aspects of life of the newborn. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
From those around I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. I hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly. At last it comes to heaven or hell, decide which now, do not delay. Come on my brothers, let us pray, decide which now, do not delay. Come on my brothers, let us pray, decide which now, do not delay. From those around I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. Hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. To be honest with you, there is no specific دليل regarding the time of circumcision.
Okay.
But it is a matter that has been discussed by doctors, by experts, and they say the younger the child is, the better.
The younger, the better. Okay.
Yeah. So, generally speaking, if that can be done in a very young age, that would be better.
That would be better.
Yeah.
As you said, there's nothing specific.
Nothing is specific from right. Sharia. And see, whenever there is to slaughter a sheep or a goat, or a cow, or a camel, to show your thankfulness to Allah Jalla wa Ala for giving you this baby.
Okay.
So this is the aqiqah.
Right.
So either aqiqah names the process itself, the aqiqah is a name for the process itself, or the aqiqah is a name for the slaughtered animal.
Okay.
This or that. This is the general meaning of the aqiqah and what it refers to.
Okay.
I hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Salim Hassani, and you're viewing this program from birth until death. We have with us Sheikh Haytham al-Haddad. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh, before, in the previous episodes, we've been talking about circumcision. And we'd just like to finish this discussion. An important question is often is, when should the circumcision be done?
Yes.
From those around I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh. Hear their footsteps leaving slow, and then I know my soul must fly. From those around I hear a cry, a muffled sob, a hopeless sigh.
No specific guidelines from Sharia,
yes,
then the matter will be flexible and what is better for the person.
Okay. Jazakallah khair for that, Sheikh. The next important point which you want to move on to is the aqiqah. I know we've mentioned it briefly, we've touched upon it in some of the previous episodes, but we'll like to start by mentioning what is the aqiqah?
Yes, bismillah. Aqiqah is to slaughter a sheep,
yes,
or a cow or a camel.